Hey guys, welcome back. So we're just gonna hop right into it. I pinned my hair back. For base, I'm going to be using the Benefit Porefessional just to have a nice smooth base. And then to put some hydration back into my face, I am going to use the Mario Badescu Rose Water Spray. And then after that sets, I'm going straight to face paint. So this is the Ben Nye White Clown Face Paint. I will have all the products down below as always. I started applying this with a foundation brush and then I realized that I never glued down my eyebrows, so I'm going in and just gluing them down with a glue stick and then going back to painting my whole entire face with the Ben Nye White face paint. I'm going back in with a makeup wedge and I'm just going to smoothen out all of the edges, especially around my hairline, and just to really smooth out any of the brush strokes that were left from using the foundation brush. And then to set the white face paint, I was using this NYX translucent powder and I realized it was taking off the white face paint instead of setting, so I went in with the Ben Nye banana powder, and I know it's banana so it's yellow, but honestly you're not even gonna see the color when I start applying all of these colors. So I'm taking a combination of these two blues. This is a Morphe palette. I will have it linked down below. Really inexpensive and the colors are amazing and blend super well. So I'm just going to be contouring. You guys will get the hang of it. I will also leave the reference picture that I used down below. It's really simple, you guys, especially since I'm doing it on camera, so you guys will definitely see what I'm doing and get the hang of it as well. But I'm just going to be contouring with these colors and I'm going to basically use all the colors of the rainbow. So I'm going in with green now and putting that on top of the blue and just making sure it's all really well blended. That's why I'm using this precision contour brush from Luxie. So now for the other side, I'm going to be taking these two colors just to make the purple a lot deeper, and I'm going to do the same exact thing. I'm going to just contour, blend it out, and then go in with the lighter color on top, which will be the red parts, and just make sure it's really nicely and well blended. I'm going to keep adding on the desired amount of color that I want and how much I want it to be blended and deepened. It's really up to you. That's why I'm going to leave the reference picture down below, but now I'm going in with the red color and I'm just going to go over it just to make it nice and seamless. So now this is where the rainbow meets. I'm going to be taking the yellow in this palette and I'm just going to put this on all of the white blank spaces except for under my cheekbones, because we're going to cover that anyways. That's why I didn't go under my cheekbones and left it white. But yeah, I'm just going to cover the middle part of my face just where the colors should meet. And then I'm going over my nose. I'm just going to do the same thing, use blue and then transition it to green. Other side, I'm going to use purple and then transition it to red. So now with some black face paints, this is just some regular Halloween black face paint from the drugstore, I think, or maybe a Halloween store. I've had it forever and it's lasted me forever as well. I'm just going to carve out like the basic structure of the skeleton. So my eyes and then the cheekbones, like I said. And then eventually I will go back and fill in everything with these same black face paints. But for right now, I'm just mapping out my reference picture basically. So really this all depends on the picture that you are referencing from, but this is the structure that I was going for. So now I'm going in and filling in all of the blank spaces with the black face paint and then letting it set and dry. Thank you. For the nose, this also depends on your reference picture. So this is how mine looked like on the picture that I used. So I'm just going to map it out again and then go back and fill it in. Now to set the black face paints, because it will move and slide, I'm going to be taking the black from the palette and just setting literally all of the black face paint with the black shadow. Going in with the NYX Black Jumbo Eye Pencil, I'm going to line my waterline and my lash line, and then blend it all out and set it with the black shadow as well, just to really make sure that my eyes have no basically opening to where you can tell there's no black. And then I'm just going to go on top of that with some shadows. So I did my right eye with blue and my left eye with purple. And then I'm just going to add some white detailing. Again, this does depend on your reference picture. And then I kind of also did my own thing with it as well and skipped some things, but this is really where you can get fun with it. Before I moved on to my face, I just coated my lashes with some mascara and then threw on some falsies. And then for detailing around my eyes, I decided to use sequins. I did this on my last Sugar School tutorial on my channel as well. I just think it gives it a lot more of a neater, precise look, because I suck at doing the detailing and scallops around my eyes. Like, I tried it the first time around filming this tutorial and it did not work out. Plus, I like the way it looks. So, and then here's where you can get fun with it. Again, you know, just do your own detailing. I did reference some of the pictures detailing as well. But, like I said, this is where you can get fun with it and make it your own. You can definitely search up different looks to do with it as well. For my lips, I actually used black gel liner and just filled them in. And then to add a little more detail, I just used the red face paint again and added like this simple teeth detailing. If you guys try this lookout, don't forget to tweet me. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in my next tutorial. Bye guys. Mwah.